Microlecture 38, Latin American Populism and Revolution. In the decades following World War II, Latin American nations experienced significant transformations associated with their integration into the world market. They also experienced difficulties opening political opportunities for their marginalized citizens. After 1945, women, workers, peasants, black populations, and indigenous communities began to claim for more opportunities and social change. As a response to their grievances, in many of the region's countries, populist politicians emerged promising change and transformation. In Mexico, the decades following the 1910 revolution saw a period of political and economic stability under the leadership of the Institutional Revolutionary Party, PRI. This party dominated Mexican politics for decades. Although they adhered to the revolution's social goals, especially land redistribution, after a few years, they were dominated by corruption and nepotism. By the end of World War II, Mexico had embraced economic nationalism, promoting development by substituting imports with domestic manufacturing and state control of key industries like the oil sector. The PRI became so powerful that they came to control official elections at every level, which reinforced traditional networks of patronage and power. The party was an intermediary between business and labor, holding the action of Mexican unions. Thanks to the PRI's actions, Mexican economy steadily grew until the 1970s, in which people at the time described as a miracle. Economic progress was not mirrored by democratic advancement. The more the PRI controlled the economy, the fewer opportunities people had to participate freely in the democratic process. In 1968, just before the Olympic Games, a student march was violently repressing what today is known as the Tlatelolco massacre. Another Latin American country in which populism had power was Argentina. After consolidating an authoritarian tradition in the first half of the 20th century, in 1946, an army colonel named Juan Domingo Perón was elected president. Perón was an emblematic political figure in Latin America, and his style of populism marked generations of Latin Americans for decades. He gained international recognition in Europe and the United States. Perón's wife, Evita Duarte, is one of the region's most famous figures and was instrumental in consolidating his power. Evita was so renowned that her impact in popular culture can be felt in the hundreds of songs, plays, books, and movies that exist about her. Evita died of cancer in 1952, but she managed to help thousands of popular class Argentinians have a better life quality before her passing. In Brazil, General Getúlio Vargas led a national dictatorship from 1937 to 1945, known as the, quote, New State, unquote. Vargas' dictatorship promised economic development, progress, and democratic reforms. However, he was inspired by European fascism and soon ended up leading a nationalist dictatorship. Despite his harsh treatment of opponents, Vargas was popular with workers and was elected in 1950 to a new term as president. In his second term, Vargas developed a populist discourse that promised nationalist economic reforms. The armed forces and conservatives mistrust Vargas' appeals to workers and organized to depose him in 1954. Before they could act, Vargas killed himself. The most important political event during the post-war period in Latin America was the Cuban Revolution's victory in 1959. After the Spanish-American War of 1898, Cuba became practically an American colony until the 1930s. During those years, a military commander named Fulgencio Batista dominated the country's politics. In March 1952, Batista staged a coup with U.S. support and instituted an authoritarian regime that favored wealthy white Cubans and U.S. businesses. The Cuban popular classes and students resisted Batista's authoritarian regime throughout the whole 1950s. From this group of people emerged a charismatic young lawyer named Fidel Castro, who in 1955, together with the Argentinian Dr. Ernesto Che Guevara, organized a guerrilla called the 26th of July in Mexico City. The 26th of July started its campaign in Cuba in December of 1956, when a group of 82 men and women land in eastern Cuba after having sailed in a boat called Granma from a port in the state of Veracruz in Mexico. The revolutionaries conduct a military campaign in the eastern part of the country that captured the world's attention. Thousands of Cubans, peasants, students, civic associations, and workers join the struggle. After 2 years of fighting the dictatorship forces, the armed insurgency seized power on January 1, 1959. The revolution pursued deep economic reforms, such as land redistribution and rent caps to help the urban poor. Since the nationalization of utilities and industries and land reform came at the expense of U.S. businesses, U.S. President John F. Kennedy, a fierce anti-communist, staged an invasion of Cuba to remove the revolutionaries from power. Formed by Cuban exiles from Miami, the invasion forced land at the Bay of Pigs, where the Cubans completely defeat them in what constitutes the first downfall of imperialism in America. In the beginning, the Cuban Revolution was not a communist revolution, but the U.S. efforts to overthrow the government and starve the Cuban economy drove them to ally with the Soviet Union. The alliance was very important in the Cold War context. In 1962, the Cuban Missile Crisis started when the Soviets moved their tactical weapons to the island. The war was, for a brief period of time, on the verge of an atomic confrontation between the two superpowers. In 1963, the United States placed a complete commercial embargo on Cuba that remains in place, although the diplomatic relations between the two countries restored in 2015. The revolutionary victory in Cuba was very influential across the whole continent. Revolutionary movements, inspired by the Cuban success, emerged in Central and South America. In the period after World War II, Latin America went through significant political changes. The continent experienced the emergence of new social movements that gave women, black populations, and indigenous communities the possibility to fight for their rights after hundreds of years of oppression. This is all I have for you today. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.